Hi, this is John Sawash, and I'm going to show you how to create a Google Group to facilitate a class discussion. Now, Google Groups is a tool that does not get a lot of regular use in the classroom. Google Classroom can do some great things and has taken over some of the responsibilities that Groups has had in the past. There are occasions, however, where Google Groups will be a helpful tool for you. One specific example would be a very detailed or large class discussion. While Google Classroom has some discussion features, evaluating and keeping track of an ongoing class discussion can be difficult in Classroom. Google Groups provides a very helpful, easy tool to do that. It supports threading, links, and is much easier to moderate and track post in Groups as compared with Classroom. So what I'm going to do is show you how to set up very briefly a discussion in Google Classroom. Now, before you can even attempt to do this, you will need to verify if your school has opened up Google Groups for your use. Some schools will restrict the ability for users to create Google Groups. It's very easy to check. Just head over to groups.google.com. And if you end up on the page that you see here with a red button that says create groups, you're good to go and you'll be able to create a group. If you do not see that button or you get a message that says this service is not enabled, you'll need to talk with your district administrator and get that turned on, or you can use a personal Gmail account to create that group. I'm going to go ahead and click create and walk you through the steps to begin. So first of all, we're just going to create a group name. We'll call this AP History. The description is not terribly important. It's very difficult to find that description, so it's doubtful that many people will be reading it. We're going to scroll down to where it says group type, and this is important. You want to change the group type to a web forum. That is a threaded discussion. Google Groups can be used for several other things, as you see here, but we're going for a discussion, so that's your best choice. Then, under the permissions, we are going to make a few adjustments. Now, if you're creating this group inside of your school's Google account, you're going to want to adjust this so that any member of your district can't join this discussion. So first of all, where it says view topics, I'm going to turn off the ability for anyone within my school district to view the topics of this conversation. You must be a member. The same thing for the posting. I don't want random students posting, only the ones in my class. And so I'm going to turn that off for all organization members. And then finally, where it says join the group, I only want the people who I have personally invited to be able to join this group. So those are the basic settings, and that's really what you need to get started. So I'm going to go ahead and click the create button, and that will create my group. And then we'll go ahead and start adding people to the group. So you'll get the message. It says a group has been created. We're going to click the link to say invite. Now, at this point, you're going to need a list of the students in your course. Now, if you're using Google Classroom, you can easily export all of their email addresses and simply copy and paste those up here in this box. This does also connect to your personal Gmail address book. And so if you know the name of your students and if they're in your address book, you can just type them in and they'll pop up as well. Once you've added their email addresses, type a short message explaining why you're sending them this invitation. Your students will need to check their email, find the link in the email, and click on it to become a member of the group. There's a lot of different settings that you can change for the group. I'm only going to show you the ones that I think are going to be relevant to the majority of you. And there's really only one, and that is your categories. We're going to go in and potentially create different categories that students will be posting questions or topics to. So I'm going to enable those categories. This is under the settings selection and then into categories. We're going to add a new category. So maybe we'll call this, since it's AP History, we'll call this Early American History. Add that category. Then we'll create another one. We'll just call this Civil War add category. And I can have as many categories as I wish. I can even create subcategories. Maybe these go along with the chapters in your textbook or important topics in your class. Students would be posting questions to those categories, and that would allow you to follow through them. I'm going to just show you what this looks like with a full discussion. So this is a group that I manage. And if I go back to the home screen of the group, I've created these topics that you can see here to kind of organize the discussion. So if someone has a general Google question, they'll post it into this category and it'll collect those in one spot. So here's a question that somebody had. There's the original response and then some back and forth people who are responding to that question. So you can see this is a little more advanced than what Google Classroom provides. I can insert images in a question, we can insert links, and it is threaded so we can see the responses back and forth. That's just a quick look at what Google Classroom, Google Groups can provide for you and your students. Give it some thought and see if it might be a helpful tool. Good luck, and I hope it works well for you.